Hello everyone, this is Lincoln, the channel for Higher Self, and welcome to the Satsang with the Self video series. For today's Satsang session, I will bring you a message from the Higher Self Consciousness. I hope that you all enjoy today's session. Dear ones, let us begin today's session by settling into our heart. For it is here within our heart that we will come to understand the greater consciousness that we are, the greater being that we are, an expression of love, an expression of life. For you see, dear one, each and every one of us has its consciousness streamed through into this world through the spiritual heart. For this, dear one, is our doorway to the multidimensional layers of our true self. Understand, dear ones, that there are many layers of expression within your manifest body, for we can look out through this physical form, through any of the five senses, and experience a different world. We can experience the world of sound, the world of sight, the world of touch and taste. But you see, dear one, there are greater worlds, worlds within ourselves, worlds within the layers of our thinking mind, the dreaming mind, the sleeping mind, and layers, dear one, deeper within our consciousness as manifest in this form. For you see, dear one, the layers of our manifest self are streamed forth through the spiritual heart. It is this doorway within our self through which our consciousness is birthed into this manifest experience of life. So, dear ones, how do you wish to know yourself? How do you wish to experience yourself? For throughout all manifest experience, the consciousness that you are is not changed. The consciousness that you are, dear one, is never affected, never reduced, never hurt nor harmed. The consciousness, dear ones, the consciousness that you are remains pure throughout all experience, throughout all expression. This, dear ones, is your divine self, the self that exists throughout all time, throughout all space, without restriction, without barrier or constraint. So, dear ones, do you desire to know this infinite aspect of your own being? Do you desire to know the source of which you are, the source that is bringing, dear ones, a piece of your consciousness into this manifest world? Do you desire, dear ones, to know your universal self? Then look and feel, dear ones. Look and feel within your spiritual heart, for this is the doorway through which your consciousness travels to manifest itself within this world, within your body, dear ones. And this heart, dear one, is forever open, for as long as you remain in existence within this body, within this world, the doorway within your heart is open, allowing your consciousness to create its experience here. And so, dear one, remove the belief that your heart is closed. Remove the belief that you cannot love within this world, for this is restricting the flow of consciousness from your own self into this manifest form. Yet the doorway, dear ones, the doorway within your spiritual heart will never close, will never shut, for as long as you, dear ones, have awareness of yourself in this body, be assured and be at peace, knowing that your spiritual heart is open here and now. So, dear ones, with this knowledge, knowing that we do not at all need to open our hearts, need to force open any believed barrier that exists within our spiritual body, we can simply place our awareness upon our spiritual heart. We can allow ourselves to surrender into this doorway. we can give ourselves the experience of the greater consciousness that we are. Understand, dear ones, that it is your mind that prevents you from going deeper into this spiritual doorway. So simply allow it to soften, allow your thoughts to reduce, allow your mind to quiet, and simply maintain feeling, maintain your inner vision, place your awareness upon your spiritual heart, and stay there, allowing your mind to flow, but not at all being distracted by the thoughts. Maintain focus, dear ones, upon your spiritual heart, and allow yourselves to come to peace. For it is your mind that acts like a magnet, pulling your awareness into the thinking body, into the mental body, and keeping you identified therein. But you see, dear ones, we can easily break free from the restrictions of the personal ego, of the thinking mind and the identification that it causes, by simply allowing us to maintain a relaxed position, a relaxed body, and placing our awareness in the spiritual heart. For you see, dear one, as the consciousness is birthed through our hearts, it travels up into the thinking center of our being, giving us conscious awareness while within this world. Yet the mistake, dear one, the mistake of our manifest selves is we believe the localized area where our consciousness resides while in this body to be our true self. We believe the thoughts within our mind to be ourselves. We believe the feelings within our body, which are registered in the area of the brain, to be ourself. We believe, dear one, all that we perceive with our five senses to be ourself and to be our world. When in truth, dear one, this is only a position that we place our consciousness within to give ourselves this experience. It is as if, dear one, the consciousness is looking through one doorway, standing on the threshold and looking out through one doorway and perceiving the world through these five senses and with this thinking mind. Yet if the higher self, dear one, the consciousness that is peeking through this window into this world, chooses to shut this door, chooses to step back and gaze around itself, it will see an infinite number of doorways opening and closing as each material and spiritual experience comes to fruition. For you see, dear one, we are birthing within our consciousness an infinite number of experiences of our true self, of our manifest potential, of our creative power. So, dear ones, close this doorway looking out into this world, temporarily. Allow yourself to return your consciousness to the greater being that you are, the awareness, the higher self. And we do this, dear one, simply by coming to a place of peace, for it is the mind that keeps us existing within this world. So we cannot think, dear one, that the power of the mind will be able to take us from this world. Do you understand, dear ones?